change advice and say people do need face masks. There's 68 million people in this country who might need multiple face masks. You're getting to the hundreds of millions of face masks need to be provided. They need it to be safe. People need to be told how to wear them and how to dispose of them. So of course that will put pressure at a time when doctors and nurses aren't getting enough face masks. And we've got sort of, there's a whole cultural issue around this. We look at,
what up, baby? Shay gave him what's happening, Paul. What's going on, people? Yes, Ryan.
If lockdown eases, and Carol, it does appear that there seem to be some concerns that should the lockdown end too early, there is a real risk of a second spike.
Of course there is, idiot.
I just think this government's future and our future.
Yeah, I'm watching the news. Just there talking about it. There's concerns that if we lift the lockdown too early, there's going to be a second spike. Of course there's going to be a fucking spike. Jesus Christ, what did I fucking expect? Yeah. Ciao ragazzi.
Gino, one second, guys. This is up and down here.
Yeah, no, up and down means up and down slowly.
Oh my god, look. Knob Hill.
Yeah. Stop and knock your night and eat some rice. Yeah, you're funny. What's going on, people? What are you doing? Black and White tomorrow, 6 o'clock. Video comes out. Big day for the streams tomorrow on Heartbreak Weather. On Black and White, let's do it. Black and White, oh God, I love this song. Very much. As I keep saying about the time we wrote it, and it was just incredible. Like the feeling, I've written hundreds of songs and never once had a feeling like that, you know. To me it's like super catchy, and the lyric, like, and yeah, the lyrics is fun, and just that everything feels really happy, and our wedding song vibes, and I could see a lot of people dancing at their wedding to this, and it just always gives really good feeling when I listen to it. Where would we be now? What time was it? I was going on about 8:30, so it's 11. It would be a couple few hours from going on stage. I'd probably be having my dinner now or going to the gym. And we'd be going on stage. Tonight I'd start getting nervous in the next hour or so. First show, start shitting myself. Would have been picking out what I was going to wear. Probably would have done it already. Ellie would be on the phone to Ellie, and Ellie would be telling me what I'm going to wear, my stylist. And this, very exciting. I know people would have been turning up at the venue now, queuing outside, getting their merch. Fletcher would be going on in a bit. Then Capaldi, and we'd be all very excited and full arena. Very cool, but you know what? There's always next year. So let's do that. It's a shame that we didn't get to do it this time, but completely out of our control for a change, and one day we'll do it again. Shame, but who is coming to the show in Nashville tonight? Who wants to get high on the tea?
THC? Mm-hmm. Yes.
PG tips. They say 5 drops or 5 milligrams of THC to a first timer is enough to get you higher than you ever want to
be. Yes, yes. In the black and white. Let me show you my guitar. You've seen this guitar before. It's my Fender Telecaster. It's in 1964. You can see it's like old and the paint's come off it. I play this a lot. I got it to play Nice to Meet You, actually. And I see us in black and white. No, I'm still not watching the news now. I've changed over to
the drops?
I think that is good though, the dropping thing. The drinking water.
Because we were standing at your door, fumbling for your keys, and I kiss you. Ask me if I wanna come inside, sweetie, don't wanna end the night. They took my hand and followed you. Yeah, I see. Crazy, bud. So, for those of you, actually, just thought of it now. If you play guitar, tune your guitar into Dad Gad. So, standard tuning on a guitar is this string is E, A, D, G, B, E. But if you tune this to D, A, D, G, A, D. So, it sounds like that open. And this is quite simple to play. So, the first one on the first note you have to play is this. So you put your finger on your index finger on the third string of the second fret. And just play it like that. Then you put your slide up to the fourth fret and put your index finger on the third string of the fourth fret and your middle finger on the top string and the bottom string of the sixth fret or the fifth fret and your next finger down the string below it on the same fret. So you need to go from there. And then slide up to the sixth and seventh frets and spread your finger. So play like a D shape like that, or an E shape that you would play. That you would play E normally down there. Play that and spread your fingers over three frets like that, over those three. You've got. I mean 7 and 9, over 7 and 9. And then slide down one fret and play the same shape as your one there. So
that first night we were standing at your door, fumbling for your keys, then I kiss you.
Back down and open it up to there's different parts that have different ways of playing the chords. So you'd kind of play that for the verse.
That first night we were standing at your door, rolling for your keys and I kiss you.
And then open it up to
ask me if I wanna come inside. It's we didn't want to end the night. Then you took my hand and I followed you.
Big one. It's just your simple four chorder. What I like about Dadgad is it the tuning. It kind of everything sounds a bit more open. You don't have to be a great guitar player to play in it. So, recap. I see us in black and white. I bend it over so you can see what frets I'm playing. Or actually, change of mind, if you don't want to play in Dadgad, you can just go, I see us in black and white. Split it up here. On the 10th and 11th fret, I see us in G. So there are two fingers there. Seven and five and six. I see us in black and white, crystal clear and solid night. And all you got, just color. I promise that I'll love you for the rest of my life. See you standing in your dress, swearing in front of all our friends. Never be another. Promise that I love you for the rest of my life. And I want the world to witness when we finally say I do. It's the way you love a guy to give it back to you. I can't promise picket fences in sunny afternoons, but at night we're cold. Could have been Nashville. Got my Nashville hat on. What could have been, people? What could have been?
Look at the state of me, man. Got it? Yes. can't wait for Black and White now. Very excited. It's a good tune. I like it. I like it a lot. Get all your local radio stations to play the shit out of it. And, I'm very excited. Have I ever been to Syracuse, New York? I have, yes. Can't wait for Black and White. No, I'm not watching the news anymore. I'm watching some show Gordon Ramsay and a couple of chefs are doing. An American road trip on ITV or something. I would be waiting outside the arena right now for the show. I know. What time is it in Nashville? 10 and 8, 7, 6. 5 p.m., is it? About 6 hours different? So, I assume Fletcher probably would have went on about 7. Would that be about right? And then Capaldi on... until about, I'd say actually I probably would have had to go on about 9. So I'd say it's Fletcher would be going on in a couple of hours. I can't remember what the stage times were going to be. I usually like to go on about 8:30. On the Flickr tour, I think I went on at 9, didn't I? There you go, John, yeah. I would have arrived at the arena a while ago. Had my dinner, maybe I probably went to the gym in the morning, maybe. Probably would have got a coffee somewhere in Nashville. Oh, stroll down to the arena. Try and keep the nerves down. First show, you're always so scared because you know you've rehearsed it so much, but Frank Lampard, you need a trip to Larry. I know Frank me and Frank have the same barber. Myself, Frank, Jimmy Redknapp, Whitehall. We have the same hairdresser, Larry, who you've probably seen on my Instagram before. And I think we could all do with a belt of a scissors, to be honest, Frank. I'd love to see you. I'd say you've started wearing your hats again. I would have been just at the arena now, just trying to relax. First show is, as I said, it was always the scariest because, like, you rehearse it so much, but it's just you in the room with the, you know, me and the band. And we never really get to perform. Last time we had like a friends and family thing where, you know, each of us brought down friends and literally friends and family down to our rehearsal room, and we just did like a mini gig to about 40 people and then went to the pub afterwards. But that was that's the closest thing you get. You go from being in a rehearsal room on your own, then arriving at the venue, doing a sound check, then on your new stage, and then you go from that to playing to 20,000 people. I don't generally get crazy nervous until I like be putting on my shoes and like put my in-ears in and doing little bits, and when you're doing those mundane tasks, it starts to kick into your head, oh shit, all these people have come to see me, I need to do a good job, you know, play our best, get everyone riled up. It's kind of it's a weird one, yeah. You get like very nervous, and then you start, I like, before I go on stage, I'm like, what are the words to that song, or how do you play that riff? I've forgotten how to play the riff. And then actually when you get there, it's completely fine. You dig yourself a hole in your head, and it's just like, shit. But once you get a couple of songs out of the way, say hello to the crowd, feed off that for a second, you get into it, and then you can get going. And that's kind of why I wanted to start the tour in Nashville. It was my idea to start the tour in Nashville. First of all, my agent lives in Nashville, which helps. I suppose that's why he probably wanted to do that too. But I needed somewhere to start somewhere in the States that was kind of like, you know, I had somewhere to, like, I know Nashville really well. I would have, like, had a whole rehearsal room there for the week with the whole production, the stage setup, etc. You know, and it's just a nice place to be getting ready for. It's a good little training camp, if you like, Nashville. And that's why I wanted to do it. And I love the crowds in Nashville as well. You know, they're music people. They really get it, and just appreciate the tunes and the. Yeah, and I really enjoyed my last show there. All the shows, my Ryman show, the show I played outside. I can't remember the name of the venue now. But yeah, Nashville's just a good place to start. I know a lot of people there. I know the city quite well, so it would have been a nice place to get going. And then I think we were in Atlanta on Wednesday, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, so I would have been just at the venue, had my dinner, probably just never going to my dressing room, because I'd be doing that many laps of the venue, going and sitting in people's offices and going into the band's dressing room and chatting with them. I wouldn't be able to sit still, I know it. Before I go on stage, I remember when I was a kid, like, I'd go to gigs and I'd be always like, I wonder what they're doing backstage. Like, I'd say it's crazy. I'd say parties all the time. And just like, I wonder what goes on. I'd look very, it's actually not as, we don't really get up to much, to be honest. We play a lot of football backstage. We play on before we go on stage, we had this game last year that we played called Footnet. And we literally just got a bike rack and you have to keep the ball off the ground. And played little games like tennis but with football, and we'd do that, and then I don't know, just general sitting around talking crap. Nothing really. I always go for a shower. I like to try and like treat going on stage like a night out. Like I got a shower for, I brush my teeth. Like I put on an aftershave and like I literally like properly get ready. Like I'm going out and my stylist has made like a PDF. Or we have it on the iPad or whatever, and it'd be like, this is what you're wearing tonight, and it'll come up. So I know what I'm wearing each night, and Mary, the girl who does my wardrobe from New Zealand, she would have all my gear lined up, my outfit on the rail in my dressing room. And yeah, I like to have the pretty dark, as you can tell, I like the dark. So my dressing room would be quite chilled out. And candles and low level lighting, and just somewhere where I can have a couple of my acoustic guitars, and you know, somewhere where I can just go and chill and have a nap if I need to. Yeah, I don't necessarily have a rider either as well. I like to have a kettle. I always drink hot water and honey. That's kind of like my drink of choice. Caffeine is not necessarily good for your voice, so I kind of tend to try and drink my coffee during the day and then stop before we go on. Any guesses how I was going to open the show? Opener, nice to meet you. Interesting. Nice to meet you. I'm seeing a lot of nice to meet yous. Small talk. Heartbreak weather. We've gone further than 2 months. Are we here? Is this the fucking thing? Black and white, slow hands. This is as authentic as it looks for content. Interesting. What songs was I doing on the B stage? Come to Brazil. Come to Brazil. Can't wait to get on a plane, fly straight to Brazil. Still bend the rules, okay? Flicker. For the love of me, okay? Okay, we are. Interesting. How would you start the show? Like, I mean, the first. Because it's more. There's obviously the poignant part is how you start, what song you start with. It's also what song you follow it with. Or how do you want to set the tone for the night? Do you want to go out of the gates, first three? I like to do like 2 songs and 3 songs and then have a chat. Get to know, you know, get the crowd really hyped up before I chat to them. Heartbreak Weather, right, okay. Interesting. So you write that. Everyone write down what they think the set list should open with. First three songs. And then we'll actually do the first four just to see how we're going. First four songs just to see what people would actually do. Would they go like that? Would they come out for on the big on the first couple, then drop down tempo wise? It's set a tone, remember? To let people know what they're getting.
I'm not saying that you're lying. I'm saying that you're lying. But you're leaving out the truth. I'm not saying that you're guilty. Cause I don't have any through. Feeling like I'm going crazy. And I don't know what to do. Cause on paper, you don't break them. But it is so bad.
Going, told me at 20%. Cross Your Mind, Heartbreak Weather, Bend the Rules. Wow, random. Nice to meet you everywhere, Cross Your Mind, then Slow Hands. Nice to meet you, Heartbreak Weather, Slow Hands, Black and White. Okay, so just really throw all the good songs out early. Nice to meet you, Black and White, dear patient, San Francisco. What, start the gig with San Francisco? No judgment, put a little love in me, Black and White, New Angel.
Barefoot in a bottle of wine. You can stay with me tonight.
Cross Your Mind, Dear Patient, No Judgment, Heartbreak Weather. Slow Hands, nice to meet you, No Judgment, jeez. Yeah, how come nobody's mentioned Everywhere? I just seen someone say that.
That's true.
No one's mentioned it. No Judgment, Heartbreak Weather, Everywhere, Black and White. She's staying up there for a long time. No Judgment, Nice to Meet You, Everywhere, Black and White. Okay.
Nice shirt, Tom. Thanks.
Interesting, people.
I'm coming with you.
Am I going to tell you? Of course not. No, not a chance. It's our little game. Any other questions? Yeah, by the way, I don't, like, when we tour again, I can't see this set list changing crazy amounts. Unless, I mean, it'd be great if I bumped into an absolute couple of, a few smashes, wouldn't it? Over the next 8 months or whatever it is. But yeah. I mean, it'd be great to come back with even bigger tunes. God, I'm like... By the way, you were all terrible at that game that we just played there. You literally just went, slow hands, nice to meet you, black and white, first three songs. Like, what? Just throw all the singles out in the first and then just leaves people sitting around not knowing anything for an hour. My favourite lyric from Black and White. I like the idea of black and white in my head, like the black being the dress, or the black being the suit, the white being the dress. But I see us in black and white, crystal clear in a starlit night, and all your gorgeous colours. So, like, more the gorgeous colours meaning personality, like all of your beautiful colours that you possess. And not just, it'd be like when I think about the song Black and White, I don't think black and white, I think more the colours part. You know, when you hear something, you think about it in a certain way. Like when I think of Slow Hands, I think of the purple colour, or the colour purple for some reason. Random things like that, just the shit that goes on in my head, I don't know. Yeah, so I see us in black and white, crystal clear in the starlit night, and all your gorgeous colours. I promise that I'll love you for the rest of your life. I also like, I want the world to witness when we finally say I do. It's the way you love, I gotta give it back to you. So good, I love that. Cheer me, so good. Niall, you are so good. And I think in that video that I posted, you can hear on the bridge, like, that's how I write. So you have the guitar just... When we started playing that guitar or that song, it was literally just kick drum. And me going... on the guitar. And that was it. And I would just sing random stuff over the top. So I'd turn on the microphone, press record, and I'd just close my eyes and just sing random melodies. And you can hear in that video that I posted me just going, I want to feel some good, and I think it's something like that, and you just blurt loads of crap out. And then you might just go, oh, fucking like that. And then go back to it later, you know? There's Corey Harper. Look at that guy. Come on, son. Harper, I seen a picture of you today working out. How do you stay in that good shape? And the amount of beer you drink. Yeah, just start blurting melodies. Like, people always say, like, how do you write songs? And it's never the same twice, first of all. But I tend to just kind of, like, just start playing random chords, or maybe I'll have a riff. But generally, it's, like, four chords together, and I just try and sing different melodies. Yeah.
Chinese food for me growing up was a treat. especially Chinese takeaway, where there's the most amazing sweet sour prawns, Sichuan pork,
duck. Oh, Peking duck.
Wow, look at this over here.
Oh, look at the festival.
The Chinese know how to celebrate.
In terms of the lyric, then, like, you'll be singing away. And obviously we have, it's one tip that I would always give to songwriters, and it's something that I kind of learned over the years. You really, before you sit down and write the song, you need to know what you're going to write about, and you need to know the story from start to finish, and what you're going to say in the first verse, and what you're going to say in the second verse, and how you want it to go. Yeah, you need to know exactly what you want to say, because that's where you get, when I get writer's block, it's because I actually don't know what I'm going to say. Like, I don't know how the story goes. I don't know where the turn is. Obviously, when you're writing a song, you want it to be honest, but you also try and add something in there to make it, like, it's like a movie. You know, not every scene is going to be boring. There's going to be a twist or a turn, you know, to make it different to anything else that you do, you know. Yeah, so if you know what you're going to talk about, that's why I write down everything in my little books. I'm actually going to go show you some stuff from the first. No one ever seen this. The only time that I've ever done intimate, it was when I put the lyrics on. Christ. Right, let me show you this. Oh God, I just found some stuff in my book. I found my book that I always use. Okay, so there we go. This is when I wrote The Tide. Not scribbling out. What was I saying there? I know it's coming again. And actually scribbled that out then. And then I wrote it out then again. Oh, look, here it is again. What was I doing? No. Oh my God, I wrote this on a separate page. This is how I started. So you see, the song's on that page, but I started writing You and Me. When I looked down the line at the man I want to be, if I was known from the start, it ends with you and me. And that's how I started the song. And then I come over here. And Ruth, who I wrote the song with, Ruth Ann, she wrote Ruthie in the corner. From a distance, I can hear you cry. Oh, Dad, look. On the same day, I think, you and me, we wrote, Seeing Blind. Root wrote at the top, tune. Oh, my, you just took me by surprise. And I can't believe my eyes. Oh, I must be seeing blind. What else have I got? Oh my God. Look what I found. I didn't even know I had this. See, I was going to say, when you feel your heart's been taken. Well, I scribbled it out and wrote loves. Jeez. Yeah, and the old line of, I'm afraid the work we had is gone. Used to be,
'Cause one of us is trying to move on.
I don't even know how it was going to fit in, but we wrote down loads of stuff.
Look in my heart, there's a light in the dark. Look in my heart. Bit of bad, there's still a flicker of. God almighty, this is nuts. Oh shit. I just... Oh Christ, some of the shite that you write went right down when you're going. Like, I just kind of walked past it and scribbled something down. Yeah, look, on the loose.
She loves the way of bad news.
That, this fucking line, honestly, she'll jump on a flight and meet you that night, make it so true. God, I might.
She'll run with your mind, she'll blow up your mind, she'll torture your mind, she'll run with your mind. So I kind of like write down three or four ideas. She'll blow up your mind, she'll torture your mind, she'll do it.
And then like pick which one I think is the best. You know, like the process of elimination thing.
She'll pull you in tight and fill you with lies. Slow hands.
Oh my God, look at this. I didn't even know I had this. I knew I had some, but...
We should take this. I've been thinking about it all day. Slow hands. That's it. And
sweat running down it was. That's even worse.
Fucking hell. I just wanna take my time. We can do this, baby, all night.
Yeah. Fingertips put in the second half of the show or the song. That is mad. Oh, this is a good song. I never did anything with it. Corners.
I see you in the corner, corners of my heart she's holding, holding on to my love, she won't let go.
My God, this is crazy, this stuff. Oh, fire away. You can see there, like, how, like, this is literally my brain just going, you know, like, you just start scribbling shit out.
You keep saying that you're alright, I can see through your fake smile or not.
So I clearly wrote that in one go. I think I wrote that whole verse in that when I was just scribbling there.
Holding back a long time, what's wrong? Yeah. So darling, you don't have to hold it. You don't have to be afraid. You can... God.
Hold me close but at a distance. Thinking I'd never listen, but I do, I like that. Mirrors, yeah. God, she closes the door, she hides behind the face, nobody knows. My God.
It's nuts, this stuff. Madness, madness, madness. Well, that was interesting. It's cool to look at that. That's how we write a song, like that. Just do that. Just random shit.
Open, close those eyes, to open up the blinds.
What am I singing? I don't know. It could be the start of something, I don't know. Have you got any other questions, maybe about music or writing or mixing or production stuff, or just any questions? My favorite chord, I love this chord. Don't even know what it is. So it'd be like, it's kind of like the fourth chord in Everywhere. One second.